Hello and welcome to Candela. This is the second lecture in our Indian Economy series for Civil Services Examination. And in this lecture, let us discuss about World Trade Organization, WTO. It's one of the youngest of the international organization. It was established in the year 1995. Let us briefly discuss the history behind the formation of WTO. In fact, it was the General Agreement on Tariff and Trade, which later got converted into WTO. It all started in 1930s with the Great Depression of 1930. I hope you all know about the Black Tuesday, October 29, 1929, when the stock markets in USA fell, and nobody could imagine that the global economy can plunge to such a historical low. During the Great Recession of 2008-2009, the GDP of the global economy fell by 1%. But during the Great Depression, the GDP of global economy fell by 15%. And USA were left with no other options to introduce a number of protectionist measures to protect the native industry and agriculture. USA then introduced the very famous, very infamous, people say, the smooth Smoot-Hawley Tariff Act. By these, they have introduced a lot of restrictions on the import of commodities into USA. They have introduced a lot of tariff barriers. Their main aim was to protect their own industry and the agriculture. The global community also retaliated. Even in Europe, the number of leading industrialized nations retaliated to USA's the Smoot-Hawley Tariff Act, and they introduced their own restriction measures. This technically, we call this as beggar the neighbor policy. Beggar the neighbor policy means, if one particular country is having an economic issue, they may try to solve that issue by creating some hardship to the neighboring countries or to the other countries. For example, there were a number of countries during the 1930s who were dependent on USA for their survival. There were many countries who were exporting large scale products to USA, and most of their economies are based on this export. USA, to protect their own industry, they imposed restrictions on this import. That is, to deal with their own economic issues, they spoiled the economy of some other countries. This is what called as beggar the neighbor policy. That is, to address one's own economic issues, targeting and spoiling some other economies or economy of some other country is called as beggar the neighbor policy. This beggar the neighbor policy is the number of protectionist measures introduced by USA and other countries. As a result, the international trade almost came to a standstill. Then came the World War II, and we better know the catastrophe which it had created. So, towards the end of the World War, in the year 1944, one conference was held in Bretton Woods in New Hampshire, USA. This conference was famously called as the Bretton Woods Conference or the United Nations Monetary and Financial Conference. The main aim of this conference was to address the economic issues of the war damaged countries. We better know Germans overran entire Poland, entire France, and even London city was bombed. There was a time when Germans were just 150 kilometers away from the city of Moscow. Had Stalin didn't get any inputs from the intelligence in the east, and had he didn't moved his troops from Siberia towards Mexico, the history might have been altogether different. And we better know to what extent the global economy got damaged because of the World War II. This United Nations Monetary and Financial Conference largely aimed at addressing the economic issues of the war damaged countries. This conference came out with two important organizations. Number one, IBRD, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. It is this which later became the World Bank. And the next organization was IMF, International Monetary Fund. These two international organizations are collectively called as Bretton Woods Twins. Bretton Woods Twins. In the same conference, there was a proposal to establish ITO, International Trade Organization. But US Congress didn't ratify or didn't agree for the creation of one more international organization, the third international organization in the conference. But the Reciprocal Trade Agreements Act of USA, the Reciprocal Trade Agreements Act of USA, permitted the US President to enter into some trade agreement with the member countries or with other countries. And simultaneously, the members who were discussing about the ITO, they continued the discussion in Geneva, and finally they established one agreement called as GATT, the General Agreement on Tariff and Trade. This was just an agreement. This was not a full-fledged organization. So this was just an agreement. And this agreement aims at minimizing the barriers for trade. Barriers for trade comes in the form of tariff barriers and non-tariff barriers. Tariff barriers, right, largely it includes import duties, while non-tariff barriers may be in the form of quality control, quantitative control. By quality control, they can prescribe that particular product in order to be fit for an export, it should satisfy these conditions. If it is a banana, hardly there should be a single spot in the banana, hardly there should be any residues. Like that, they can specify some particular quality foreign product to become fit for export. Quantitative control means they can just restrict the amount of the quantity of product that can be exported or that can be imported by a particular country. So how much USA can import from India, they can restrict that. GATT aimed at minimizing the barrier for trade. The members of GATT countries, they met at regular intervals, and they negotiated the issues concerning the global trade, and these negotiations are called as negotiating rounds. So GATT was established in the year 1947. For first 30 years, God was successful in increasing its members, and they were successful in minimizing a number of issues concerning international trade, minimizing the barriers to trade. But towards the end of 1980s, there were few issues which God couldn't address. There were a number of new issues which were surfacing in international trade which God was not in a position to address. These issues, right, these are like the issues concerning dispute resolution. So if there is a rule under this agreement, and if a member country breaks the rule, and if they are not obeying the rule, and if it creates a dispute, how this dispute is going to get addressed here? There was no proper mechanism. In fact, even in WTO, this dispute resolution mechanism is not so proper. Okay, but this was one major issue. Then there were a number of commodities like agriculture, textiles, which were kept away from the scope of GATT. Then service sector, international trade in services were increasing at a very rapid rate, and it was becoming so important. But this general agreement on trade, tariff on trade, deals only with trade in commodities and not in services. So there was a need to include some rules and regulations regarding trade in services. The next very important issue is issues related to intellectual property. This was one particular issue which was really frustrating many developed nations. So most of the intellectual work created in these countries got pirated in many other countries, and there were no rules related to protection of the intellectual properties. But now in WTO, we have the very famous TRIPS, trade related aspects of intellectual property rights, which deals strictly with the intellectual property rights violation. But earlier GATT was not in a position to deal with the intellectual property. Along with this, there were some rules related to trade and investment. If one country is going to invest in some other country for trade, there are some issues like, or there are some rules like domestic purchase agreement or domestic purchase requirement. For example, if BMW is going to invest in India, so earlier there was a rule. So when they invest here, when they start a new plant here, at least some particular proportion of or some particular portion of the materials used there should be manufactured by a local producer. Then will they agree to come and invest here? They have their own quality standards, right? Starting from these screws and nuts they use, they have their own quality standards. And if you have this type of agreement, will it be possible for people like our corporates like them to come and invest in other countries? So like this, there were few issues which are not which GATT was not in a position to address. As a result, in the very famous Uruguay round of trade negotiation, Uruguay round of trade negotiations in the year 1986, and it continued up to 1994. So there was a discussion. They tried to improve these general agreement on tariff and trade into a full-fledged organization. But year after year, the members continue to negotiate, but nothing was happening. On one fine day, Arthur Dunkel, the then Director General of GATT, Very recently, Arthur Dunkel died. What a fantastic personality he was. He was then not the Director General of GATT. This man, he got really frustrated looking at the way in which the negotiations were going on. On one fine day, right, he personally decided to sit and do all the work. He collected almost all the relevant materials on the contents which were negotiated for in the Uruguay round of trade negotiations. Painstakingly, he sat and he made one draft, which was popularly called as Dunkel's proposal or Dunkel's draft. Arthur Dunkel. And his personality and using his caliber, he managed to convince the member countries, and finally he made the member countries to accept to the draft, and one agreement was signed in Marrakesh, Morocco. Which finally established the WTO. So remember, it is the Uruguay round of a trade negotiation number one. The Uruguay round of trade negotiations. Then number two, Dunkel's draft or Dunkel's proposal, and then the Marrakesh agreement. It is these three which created the WTO, World Trade Organization. So in the next lecture, let us discuss about the principles of trading under WTO. So what is the purpose for which it was created? How it is going to create, how WTO aims at creating a fair and uniform rule-based trading, rule-based international trade. How it is capable of dealing with the dispute resolution. How through various agreement it deals, is going to deal with the number of issues related to trade in services. So that we'll be discussing in the subsequent lectures. Thank you.